Spirit, when you touch Jesus, when you touch his word, when you touch his heart.
Esther
was to touch the golden scepter. Elisha was to touch the mantle. The woman with the issue of blood was to touch also the mantle of Jesus Christ. What are you planning to touch in your life? Now, for the woman with the issue of blood, she touched the garment of Jesus Christ. She was made whole. She was made whole in secret. Jesus made it open, and she received healing for herself. There had not been no fasting, no three-day fasting, no nothing. All she has to do is to just have faith. But I love the touch of Esther. For Esther to touch the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, though she's been in the palace, she's a queen. She has no access to the King of Kings. But for her to touch that golden scepter, she has to die. He said, if I perish, I perish. The woman with the issue of blood didn't say that. And I thank God for what she touched. But you remember that Esther said, if I perish, I perish. And she touched that golden scepter. And I touched, saved an entire nation. She was able to touch the golden scepter. And she entered the golden phase of her life. God is raising many Esthers in the body of Christ. This is not gender based. The spirit of Esther is being poured upon so many. We engage in fasting and praying, and they will be interceding just for the kingdom. Who know it that you have come to the kingdom for such a time as this? Esther touched the golden scepter, and a nation was delivered from the destructive arm of a man called Haman. It's your turn. Maybe your focus has been to touch, to get personal healing, and for your own personal deliverance is now for you to touch for nations of the earth to be saved from destruction. God bless you. And I look forward to seeing you this Sunday. Not just this Sunday, but next Tuesday, Power of Godliness, and Jesus' Fast, Jesus' Prayer on Thursday. Check our website, and God bless you.
Okay, so I give glory to God, and I thank God for my mother and father and the Lord. Okay, so really quick, last Sunday, I shared the testimony that I had got interviewed, right? So they ended up hiring me, and I thank God for that. But at my internship, Lord Jesus, I was afraid to wear this shirt. The shirt says, Jesus is God, in big, bold letters, and it says, I dare you to tell me otherwise. And I wanted to represent Jesus, but I was kind of afraid because I thought they was going to fire me. But I was like, you know, if the Muslims could wear their little wraps, I could do it. So I wore it, right? And we had this festival where the community I live in, they came about, right? So I was able to talk to a couple of people about Jesus Christ, and I just thank God for that, for using me to sow seeds, because if you know, that shirt brought people to, you know, ask questions about Jesus. Also, I got my driver's license renewed. Also, I just thank God for his word and Daddy Child's Hidden Manna book, because I was able to judge myself and learn where I need to grow. So I thank God.